Everybody is locked back here. Okay, y'all, it's time to have some fun. It's Beauty Shop Banter time. So, what's Beauty Shop Banter? You cannot have old school barbershop, beauty shop conversation without something serious coming out of something silly. So, this week, I think I want to talk about bobbleheads. Like, what is that? Lisa, what is a bobblehead? Okay. I know I'm not the only stylist that is trying to do your client's hair. Client will remain anonymous, and they're doing this. I know I'm not the only one, right? So it begins to be annoying, right? Because I'm trying to do your hair. I'm a sister light consultant. I might be in your hair 2, 3, maybe 4 hours, and I'm doing this the whole time that I'm trying to do your hair. So that's annoying. So I was talking to some of the other clients and trying to figure out what's the best way to tell somebody they need to keep their hair still. And from a stylist perspective, that can be a little bit annoying when you're trying to be effective. You want to get in and out. I know if I'm spending 3 hours in your hair and I want to go home too, if I have to keep positioning your hair and your head and turning it because you're sleepy, probably not a good look. But you can't just kick them out your chair, right? You're not gonna listen to the peanut gallery on the live. I think some of them would. Anyway, so I was trying to think about it. I thought it would be a good discussion for Beauty Shop Banter today. And I think the biggest thing with dealing with clients is you have to kind of put yourself in your shoes. It's like doing side work for a waitress. You don't want to have to clean up behind the messy kids at table 4, but you have to. So one of the biggest things that helped me kind of get over that was thinking about the client and where they're coming from. So if I know a client is constantly coming in at a certain time of day, and they work at, let's say, the hospital, and they're just tired, I might want to talk to them about maybe scheduling another time. If that's not feasible, I might have to work around. So one of the things that I did was I got a barber chair. Why did I get a barber chair? Well, because it allows you to recline the client all the way back. So one of the ways that I kind of work around the bobblehead syndrome is to strategically work around their head. So especially my sister lot clients, I will work on the back of their hair when they first come in and they're energized and they at least have enough energy from the drive over. Do the back of their hair and then I will rotate. When they start doing the bobbing and weaving, then I lightly recline them back. And it actually makes them feel better because they're like, oh, wait, she fancy. When really I'm just saying, just go to sleep. So I can do what I need to do. And I can do, for the most part, the entire front of their hair. Now, if you are doing something like, you know, a silk press, that's probably not going to help you out and you're going to have to be more creative. Maybe just talk to them more. Or if you realize that maybe they're coming right after work, their energy level might be low because their sugar level is low, so they might need to eat something. So we have a little snack bar, whatever here, tea, coffee, or whatever you decide you want to put there. Offer them something to eat to get their energy up. But I think it'll be fun. I want to see some of your pictures. So follow me on Instagram or email me info@thelockbackhairstudio.com. I want to see hashtag bobblehead wars. I'm serious. I want to see the videos because I know I got a couple. I'm going to probably start it off and post one. I know that you have some. I know I'm not the only stylist that have caught their client slipping. Don't put your client face in it if they don't say they can. But I do want to see it. Hashtag bobblehead wars. At the like that easy. Thanks, guys, for listening. I will be sure to get back with you with some more content. Be sure to like, subscribe, follow us on Instagram @thelockbackaz. We'll talk to you later. Peace.